Good morning, Wolfpack. I'm Kayla Yota.
And I'm Irene Milanes.
Today's Wednesday, October 2nd, and we're here with your morning announcements.
Girls Who Code is meeting in HF2, Mrs. Hale's room, during Wolfpack Hour to design and create their very own vinyl stickers. All are welcome.
Attention, Wolfpack artists. The library invites you to participate in an upcycled book contest. This contest where artists will transform a book into a work of art. This book will be provided to you and alter the book any way you want. All entries must be turned in by October 29th. All altered books will be turned in into a piece of art will be displayed in the library in November. Prizes will be awarded to first, second, and third place, as well as three prizes for honorable mention. This contest will be open to all COA staff and students. See Ms. Liu or Ms. Hope Witzel in the library for entry forms or books.
Hey Wolfpack, The Outlet is coming up in January, a place for expression without judgment put on by the Thespian Society. If you're interested in submitting a piece of writing for The Outlet or just curious to see what that would entail, we'll be giving the opportunity to come to our writing workshops held every other Thursday in the theater room, HU5, from 3:15 to 4. We want your voices to be heard.
Attention freshmen, you need some additional support for studying for finals? Your leaders are here to help. Link Crew is hosting a cram with a pack session after school Wednesday, October 9th from 3:30 to 5 in HL3. Come get help with Math 1 and Math 2, Spanish, and any other subject that you're struggling with. And snacks will be provided.
We are starting the process of selecting students who will be participating in the Osaka Exchange Program for the 2019-2020 school year. If you are or were in Japanese class and interested in going to participate, please contact Ms. Tanaka or visit her classroom at HM5. The due date for the application is October 18th.
Due to unforeseen circumstances, the student store will be closed this week. Purchases can be still made after school in the controller window every day after school.
There will be a club meeting for both Engineering Club and Lead Club on Thursday at 3:20 p.m. in HF5. All students interested in these clubs should plan to attend.
Now let's pass it over to Kevin and Edward for our In the News report.
Good morning, Wolfpack. I'm Kevin Kativa.
And I'm Edward Agapito, and we're here for your In the News update.
Hey, that rhymed. Bernie Sanders is hospitalized for heart procedure and cancels his future campaign events until further notice. He was treated for an artery blockage after experiencing chest discomfort during a campaign event. Mr. Sanders was traveling for a gun forum in Las Vegas and was to travel to California later this week. Unfortunately, he is currently recovering in a Las Vegas hospital, the campaign said.
Ohio Governor Mike DeWine on Tuesday called on state lawmakers to pass a ban on most e-flavored cigarettes, saying he was alarmed by the nationwide surge in the sometimes deadly lung disease linked to vaping nicotine or marijuana e-cigarettes. DeWine said he wanted the General Assembly to ban all flavored vaping products besides tobacco flavor, including mint and menthol flavored products, asserting to the reporters that if we do that, we will reduce the health risk and will certainly save lives.
Mm-hmm. On to local news, the first animal shelter opens in Elk Grove. The animal shelter opened to the public over the weekend, and it offers services and housing for escaped, abandoned, and adoptable pets. The shelter provides spay and neuter, adoption, foster, and reunification programs for hundreds of animals each year. It is located at the corner of Iron Rockway and Union Parkway off Highway 99, and the long-awaited animal shelter will operate Tuesday through Sunday, noon to 6 p.m. Its grand opening will be held the morning of October 12th.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Wolfpack. Back to you, anchors.
Thanks, guys. Juniors and seniors signed up and started for presentations by representatives from University of San Francisco, CSU in Monterey Bay, UC San Diego, UC Santa Cruz, San Diego State, and Sonoma State. If too many sign up, seniors will get priority, and then juniors.
Seniors, if you will be applying for four-year colleges, you must take the SAT or the ACT. You do not need to take it for community college. The deadline is November 2nd. The SAT is this Thursday, October 3rd, and this is the last SAT that Cal Poly and San Diego State will accept for the fall 2020 admission.
Juniors and sophomores who plan to attend a four-year college after graduation are strongly encouraged to take the PSAT on October 16th. National Merit Scholars and Scholarships are determined through your junior year PSAT scores.
The PSAT is on sale now and may be purchased at the student store after school at the controller's window. The cost is $18 and registration closes October 4th.
Sophomores, the school district has planned For your PSAT, you will receive an informational about the PSAT in your AVO. You do not need to sign up.
The FAFSA is now open. Whether or not you think you're eligible for aid, you should complete this. The FAFSA is required to get 2 years free at community college and will help the cost of a four-year college. COHS is hosting a financial aid night tomorrow at 6 p.m. in the MP room. Bring your parent and guardian and find out about applying for free money to help you with the cost of attending college.
There will be an interact meeting today after school in HN2. Come meet new people and prepare for the Purple Pinky Project. All are welcome.
Before we go, let's check out your Hispanic heritage fun fact.
Hi, my name is Alex Mendez, and today's influential person is Lionel Messi. Lionel Messi is an important and well-known Latin American because he won the Ballon of Oro 5 times, which means he's the world's best soccer player. In addition, he teamed up with the UNICEF to stop children's deaths from preventable causes such as diseases and being underprivileged.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Wolfpack. I'm Kayliota.
And I'm Irene Melanes. Remember, the strength of the pack is the wolf.
And the strength of the wolf is the pack. Happy National Name Your Car Day! Woo!